Now, my colleague, the topic today is sepsis. Sepsis, it is an infection disease which caused by endogenic bacteria, which cause the formation, general forms of infection, polyorgan insufficiency, and metastatic focus of infection. There are many cofactors of infection, of sepsis. For example, immunodeficiency conditions. For example, weak immune response, weak reactivation of T lymphocytes, it causes the formation of bacteremia, endotoxinemia, and formation of general focus of infection. Comorbid conditions, severe concomitant disease, immunodeficiency condition, for example, atherosclerosis, diabetes, disorders of function of different organs, cause the formation of immunodeficiency conditions. For example, respiratory insufficiency, cardiovascular insufficiency, liver insufficiency, renal insufficiency, cause the formation comorbid conditions and immunodeficiency syndrome. Invasive manipulation, which causes the formation of primary focus of infection on the skin, for example, cosmetological, medical manipulations, gynecological, stomatological manipulation, cause those formation of primary focus of infection. Next moment, massive invasion of bacteria. Formation of massive bacteremia, formation of weak immune response, and formation of general forms of infection. Next, antigen mimicry, when proteins of bacteria is like as proteins of macroorganism. Yes, it causes the weak immune response. And aggressive abilities of microorganisms. For example, exotoxins of bacteria cause increasing of permeability of blood vessels, formation of bacteremia, endotoxinemia, formation decreasing of immune response, decreasing immune reactions, formation of general forms of infections. So it causes the formation of generalization of infection and formation of metastatic focus of infection. So all those cofactors cause the formation of sepsis. There is correlation between localized forms of infection, primary focus of infection, and type of microorganism. For example, if primary focus of infection localized in biliary system, it characterizes formation cholangitis, cholecystitis, dyskinesia of bile ducts. More often infection agent is endogenic bacteria, gram-negative bacteria, Escherichia coli, Protei, Klebsiella, Staphylococcus, and other bacteria. If primary focus of infection localized in urinary system, formation of cystitis, urethritis, prostatitis, cause the formation of Escherichia coli, Klebsiella, Protei, gram-negative bacteria. For example, respiratory system is characterized by formation bronchitis, bronchopneumonia, And bacteria more often is caused by bacteria, for example, staphylococcus, pneumococcus, streptococcus, which cause the general forms of infection. Urogenital system, for example, prostatitis, salpingoarthritis, urethritis, and infection agent is Escherichia coli, Klebsiella, Protei, and other bacteria. Anaerobic bacteria, Clostridium, and bacteroids. Next, infections of skins and infections of mucous membrane, for example, pyodermia, streptodermia, stomatitis, necrotic stomatitis, bacterial stomatitis, which infection is anaerobic bacteria, which cause the anaerobic sepsis. Parodontitis, for example, periodontitis, cause the formation anaerobic infection. And infection of skin, for example, staphylococcus, streptococcus formation, pyodermia, and streptodermia. Let's speak about pathogenesis of sepsis, for example. We spoke about primary focus of infection, formation of local forms of infection at first, then bacteria penetrate to blood, formation bacteremia and toxinemia. Bacteria synthesis of exotoxins and it causes activation of neutrophils, phagocytes, synthesis inflammatory cytokines, for example, interleukin 1, interleukin 6, 8, 12, and tumorous necrosis factors alpha. So those mediator cause destruction of endothelium of capillaries, cause the formation of thrombosis of blood vessels, and cause activation of formation of thrombosis, disturbances of microcirculation, ischemia, and metabolic disturbances of tissue, of organs. Then mechanism, for example, when mediator of immune response cause alteration of proteins of membrane of the cells of macroorganism, and it causes activation of autoimmune mechanism. It causes the formation of immune complex, which causes the destruction of the cells of macroorganism and formation of target organs. So, endotoxinemia, bacteremia, cause decreasing of blood pressure, spasm of arterial, centralization of blood vasculation, ischemia of internal organs, paresis of blood vessels, formation of thrombosis of blood vessels, activation of hemorrhagical syndrome, disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome. So it causes the formation of polyorgans insufficiency of the patients and metabolic disturbances. We spoke, ischemia of different organs, centralization of blood vasculation, immune mediator cause the destruction of proteins of the cells and activation of mechanism of autoaggressions, synthesis of immune complex destruction of different organs and formation of target organs. For example, myocarditis, nephritis, hepatitis, vasculitis, arthritis. So it causes the formation of polyorgans insufficiency. Disturbances of blood vasculation, spasm of arterioles, and paresis of arterioles, characterized by formation of ischemia ischemia of internal organs, and metabolic disorders, and increasing of permeability of blood vessels. Yes, we spoke about that bacteria's synthesis of exotoxins. Exotoxins cause the depression of immune response, cause increasing of permeability of blood vessels, formation of massive bacteremia, and then bacteria penetrate to internal organs and formation of metastatic focus of infection. For example, metastatic focus formation in the liver, in the lung, in the brain, in joints. So, for example, if metastatic focus formation in the liver, which causes the formation of mechanical jaundice, abdominal pain, hypertransaminasemia. If metastatic focus of infection localized in the lung, it causes the formation of pneumonia, respiratory insufficiency, destruction of the lung. Then, bacteria penetrate to gametoencephalic barrier and formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, neurological syndrome, chronic cramps, and others. So, and terminal stage of sepsis is septic shock. Septic shock is characterized by decreasing of blood pressure, spasm of arterioles, paresis of blood vessels, centralization of microcirculation, formation of cardiovascular insufficiency, lung, pulmonary insufficiency, and renal insufficiency, formation of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome, stage of hypercoagulation, and then disseminated of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome. So and terminal conditions when formation polyorgans insufficiency and death of the patient. So main mechanism of pathogenesis is ischemia of different organs, metabolic disorders, formation of target organs, cytokine storm, which causes formation of target organs, myocarditis, nephritis, pneumonia, arthritis, vasculitis, yes, and formation of metastatic focus of infection. Let's speak about the clinic of sepsis. For example, we speak at first about early symptoms of sepsis. Fever, intoxication, splenomegaly, inflammatory alteration of blood, hemorrhagical vasculitis, hemorrhagical exanthem rash, hemorrhagical rash, tachycardia. So, for example, fever. Yes, what characteristic of the fever in the patient with sepsis? It's characterized by, at earlier stage, it's characterized by subfebrility temperature, atypical temperature. Yes. Later stage of sepsis, formation of gectic fever, febris remittens, and gectic fever, when the temperature is more than 40 degrees, and then decreasing for normal or subnormal level. So, syndrome of intoxication, marked intoxication, increasing of the temperature accompanied increasing of syndrome of intoxication. It's characterized by formation of encephalopathia, toxic encephalopathia, somnolence. Yes. And then symptoms. Splenomegaly, then gepotomegaly. Splenomegaly indicate in on the first days of sepsis, and gepotomegaly indicate on the second or third week of infection. Inflammatory alteration of blood, leukocytosis, neutrophilosis, yes, because bacteremia, activation of phagocytosis, so and such symptoms. So hemorrhagical vasculitis, so because exotoxin increasing of permeability of blood vessels and formation of hemorrhagical elements of the skin, and so formation of hemorrhagical rash, hemorrhagical vasculitis. There are different size of hemorrhagical element: petechia, purpura, ecchymose, massive hemorrhagical rash with necrosis. So it is hemorrhagical vasculitis. Later we will look at the picture with the syndrome. For example, hypotoxic forms of fulminant forms of sepsis characterized by formation of hemorrhagical, massive hemorrhagical elements on the skin with necrosis. Hemorrhagical exanthem, hemorrhagical rash on the body of the patients. Tachycardia, characterized by formation cardiovascular insufficiency. Dyspnea, characterized by formation of respiratory insufficiency. So we must remember that the patients with immunodeficiency conditions, there is no high fever, there is no leukocytosis. So it's characterized by the normal or subnormal temperature. And there is no leukocytosis. It's characterized by formation of leukopenia, for example. Yes, it's characterized by a reactivity of immune response. It is non-favorable prognosis in those patients. Then we spoke about increasing of permeability of blood vessels and penetration bacteria in different organs and formation of metastatic focus of infection in the liver, lung, brain, joints. For example, formation of metastatic focus in the liver characterized by formation mechanical jaundice, hyperbilirubinemia, hypertransaminazemia, abdominal pain in right iliac region, abscess of the liver, yes, abdominal pain, yes, metastatic focus in the lung characterized by destruction pneumonia, respiratory insufficiency, purulent sputum. Then penetration bacteria to hematoencephalic barrier caused the formation of metastatic focus of infection in the brain. It is characterized by neurological syndrome, paresis, paralysis, headache, chronic cramps, toxic encephalopathia, loss of consciousness. Then formation of metastatic focus in joints characterized by arthritis, purulent arthritis. So different localization of metastatic focus of of infection in the latest stage of sepsis. Then we spoke about activation of mechanism of autoaggression, synthesis of immune complex mechanism, synthesis of autoantibodies, which cause the destruction of different organs, different cells, and formation of nephritis, hepatitis, myocarditis, and vasculitis. So hyper transaminosemia, hyper creatininemia, decreasing of diuresis. In those patients. Formation of destruction alveolitis, for example, respiratory insufficiency, acute distress syndrome, and acute respiratory insufficiency, destruction of alveoles, formation of fibrinic patch on alveoles. And cardiovascular insufficiency, for example, endotoxinemia, exotoxinemia, cause decreasing of blood pressure, tachycardia, spasm of arterioles, disturbances of microcirculation, paresis of arterioles, and formation of thrombosis, microthrombosis of blood vessels. Acute respiratory insufficiency, acute respiratory distress syndrome, renal failure, renal insufficiency, increasing creatinine in blood, urea in blood. Гематурия, протеинурия. Liver insufficiency, characterized by hyperbilirubinemia, hypertransaminosemia. Adrenal insufficiency, characterized by decreasing of the temp of arterial blood pressure, decreasing of the temperature, and formation of massive hemorrhagical elements on the skin with necrosis. And terminal stage of sepsis is septic shock, and we indication compensative, subcompensative, and decompensative stage of septic shock. Compensative phase characterized by initial symptoms of shock, decreasing of blood pressure, marked intoxication, encephalopathia. Some compensative stage characterized by progressive of cardiovascular insufficiency and decreasing of diuresis, dyspnea, renal insufficiency, and respiratory insufficiency, acrocyanosis, diffusion cyanosis, hyperbilirubinemia, hypertransaminosemia, increasing level of creatinine in blood. So, and decompensative stage of shock characterized by disorders of microcirculation. Disorders of microcirculation in internal organs and formation of decompensation forms of metabolic disorders, polyorgans insufficiency, and death of the patient. And disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome is accompanied of septic shock and general forms of infection because synthesis of exotoxins and endotoxins cause activation of coagulation, formation of thrombosis of blood vessels. For example, there are four stages of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome. For example, the first stage is hypercoagulation stage. It's characterized by decreasing of index of coagulation less than 4 minutes. Next stage, second stage, is coagulopathia of consumption. Coagulopathia of consumption when coagulation index of coagulation is more than 15 minutes. Decreasing of the level of thrombocytes. The level of thrombocytes in intervals 140 and 150 cells in 1 microliter. Then third stage of coagulation, stage progression of coagulation, it's characterized by decreasing of index, increasing of index of coagulation is more than 15 minute, and decreasing of level of thrombocytes low than 100 cells in 1 microliter. Decreasing the index of coagulation is more, increasing the index of coagulation is more than 15 minute. Then stage of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome is general coagulation. General coagulation. Coagulation index is more than 20 minutes and decreasing the level of thrombocytes is less than 100 cells in 1 microliter. In those stage, formation of massive hemorrhagical elements on the skin with necrosis. For example, nausea, vomiting with blood admixtures, diarrhea with blood admixtures, bleeding from stomach and others syndrome. So, and the patients with sepsis, we indicate coagulation index, yes, coagulogram, the level of thrombocytes, fibrin, for diagnostic of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome. Let's speak about classification of sepsis. For example, the indication, we reveal some variants of classification. For example, depends of primary focus of infection. The indication, tonsillogenic, uregenic, intestinal, surgical, obstetric, gynecological, odontogenic. So in cases of tonsillogenic sepsis, infection agent is streptococcus, for example. Uregenic infection agent is Klebsiella, Protei, Escherichia coli. Intestinal sepsis, infection agent is Escherichia coli, for example. Surgical sepsis, maybe. Staphylococcus, Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Obstetric sepsis. Infection agent is Escherichia coli, Protei, Klebsiella. And odontogenic sepsis. Infection agent is anaerobic bacteria, Clostridium and Bacteroides. Gynecological sepsis. Anaerobic bacteria. For example, Bacteroids and Clostridium. So we indication some forms of sepsis, acute forms, fulminant forms, chronic forms, aerobic, anaerobic. And we indication acute forms of sepsis, for example, we indication acute forms when polyorgans insufficiency formation after 4 or 5 days of beginning of infection. Fulminant forms, hypotoxic forms of sepsis, we indication when polyorgans insufficiency formation after 1 or 2 days after beginning of infection. Chronic forms of sepsis, vindication when polyorgan insufficiency and metastatic focus of infection, formation after many weeks, sometimes many months, yes. The indication aerobic, anaerobic bacteria. Anaerobic, it causes the formation of clostridiums, bacteroids. Gram-positive, gram-negative sepsis, they are variants of classification 2. Now, and the next classification, we use those classification in clinic of infections. It is classification of general infection process. The indication 5 stage, for example, bacterial culture without systematic inflammational reaction. It is very seldom variants, but it can may be. Second variant, systematic inflammational reaction without bacterial culture. So what does it mean, systematic inflammational reaction? It is clinic of sepsis, fever, intoxication, leukocytosis, cardiovascular insufficiency, dyspnea, tachycardia, decreasing of diuresis. So it is systematic inflammational reaction. But without bacterial culture, yes. Next variant, sepsis, it's characterized by systematic inflammational reaction plus bacterial culture. So the indication, fever, intoxication, respiratory insufficiency, cardiovascular insufficiency, leukocytosis, dyspnea, decreasing of diuresis. Yes, and in those patients, the indication bacterial culture. We confirm diagnosis with indication of bacteria in blood. Sepsis severe forms, next stage, fourth stage, sepsis severe forms. It tries by the later variants of infection, formation of multi-organ insufficiency, and metastatic focus of infection. Metastatic focus in the liver, lung, brain, joint, and others localization. And terminal stage is septic shock. It's characterized by general forms of infection, which with polyorgan insufficiency and disorders of microcirculation of internal organs, centralization of blood vasculation, decompensation of metabolic disorders, which cause the death of the patient. Let's speak about diagnostic of sepsis. What indication for diagnostic of sepsis? There are the patients with prolonged fever, yes, and systematic general inflammation reaction. So fever, intoxication, leukocytosis, polyorgan insufficiency, yes, it is indication for diagnostic of sepsis. Immunodeficiency patients. Patients with immunodeficiency conditions, patients with severe concomitant disease, and others. And what methods, laboratory methods for diagnostic of sepsis? At first, the main methods for confirmed diagnosis is indication of blood culture. Blood culture. For example, 10 milliliter of blood and 100 milliliter of medium, yes. Then bacteriological examinations. Results with indication after 4-5 days. Then chromatography, methods of immunoelectrophoresis when the indication antibodies of bacteria and connection with bacteria. Then antigen rapid test when the indication DNA of the virus, it is express diagnostic of sepsis. Then biochemical diagnostic, for example, we use the procalcitonin test. Procalcitonin test, increasing of the test 0.5 nanogram per milliliter. Indication of presepsin, it is an immunological factor, it is receptor when which we indication on immune cells in general forms of infection. We indication receptor SCD14S10. So it is immunological diagnostic. Yes, presepsin, procalcitonin test, it is biochemical test. So indication of interleukins, interleukin 8, 6. So it characterized by cytokine storm in the patients and formation of polyorgans insufficiency, toxicometabolic disorders by ELISA methods. Then the indication fibrin, fibrinogen, coagulogram, leukocytes, transaminase, creatinine, so C-reactive proteins too. So all biochemical tests, all biochemical finding important because formation polyorgans insufficiency. So I repeat, the indication creatinine, transaminase, fibrin, the level of thrombocytes, fibrin, C-reactive proteins, products of destruction of fibrin and coagulogram. Now we spoke about etiology, cofactor, pathogenesis of sepsis, and the clinical symptoms of sepsis. Let's speak about treatments of sepsis. At first, we speak about antibacterial therapy when we indication antibiotics to the patients with general forms of infection. It is mainstream of the treatment. We administer anticoagulant for prophylactic of thrombosis. Yes, we spoke about formation of thrombosis of blood vessels. Then inhibitor of fibrinolysis. If increasing of products of destruction of fibrin. Immune treatment. Administer some immune medicates. Detoxication infusion therapy. Anti-cytokine therapy because synthesis of inflammational cytokines and cytokine storm. And improvement of microcirculation. So such forms of the treatments of the patients of sepsis. At first, let's speak about antibacterial therapy. We administer cephalosporins plus aminoglycosides. Cephalosporins plus fluoroquinolones. Cephalosporins plus metrogyl. It is initial treatments, initial antibacterial treatment of the sepsis. Because bacterial culture we indicate after 4 or 5 days, and we must administer treatment emergency to the patient with general forms of infection. 2 antibiotics intravenously in maximal doses. Cephalosporins plus aminoglycosides intravenously. Cephalosporins plus fluoroquinolones intravenously. Cephalosporins plus metrogyl intravenously. In maximal doses. So, main bacteria, when the indication is, when we administer blood culture, yes, we indication bacteria in blood culture. Then we administer, we indicate antibiotic gram, yes, sensitivity of bacteria to antibiotics. So, and we know that more often, if the indication, Staphylococcus aureus, for example, we administer cephalosporins. If the indication Staphylococcus epidermidis, it is methicillin resistant forms of staphylococcus, we administer lincosamine glycopeptide or carbapenems. Next. If we reveal from blood Escherichia coli or Klebsiella, so gram-negative bacteria, we administer fluoroquinolones. Next, if we indicate Pseudomonas aeruginosa, we administer азлоцилин, мезлоцилин, карбеницилин. If we indicate Clostridium, so if it is anaerobic sepsis, we administer metrogyl and vancomycin. Metrogyl and vancomycin. So, antibiotics we administer intravenously with maximal doses, in maximal doses. Then correction of fibrinolysins if increasing of products of destruction of fibrin, for example, hypercoagulation. We administer Contrical, Gardox, Proteanin. For example, Contrical dose is 10,000 units on 1 kilogram of mass of patients. For example, Contrical doses is 10,000 units on 1 kilogram of mass of patients. If formation of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome, we administer plasm of blood, prothrombin complex, inhibitor of fibrinolysis, angioprotector. Then prevention of thromboembolic complication, we administer heparin for prophylactic of thromboembolic complication, we administer heparin. And immune therapy because it is immunocompromised patient, we administer immunoglobulins, which connect of antibodies of wide spectrum of activity. For example, intraglobulin, pentaglobin, intravenously. For activation of immune response, we administer Ronelikin, Immunofan. So this medicate activate phagocytosis and T lymphocytes. In cases of higher level of inflammatory cytokines and polyorgans insufficiency and formation of target organs, we administer infliximab, pentoxifilin, tocilizumab, so it is anti-cytokine therapy for depression of synthesis inflammational cytokines. Detoxication, infusion therapy, glucose solutions, salt solutions, crystalloids, albumins, Remaxol, Reambirin. Sometimes we administer plasmapheresis of the patients. So such methods of the treatments of sepsis, the patients of the sepsis. So we can discharge patient from hospital after normalization, stabilization of clinic, normalization of laboratory biochemical test. Yes, then we must examine the patients during 2 years, yes, after those infection. After 6 months, we invite those patients for examinations, blood picture, biochemical test, blood culture, and sanation of chronic focus of infection and immunorehabilitation. You see the picture of the patients with hemorrhagical vasculitis. You see increasing of permeability of blood vessels, formation of hemorrhagical elements on the skin. Yes, it is hemorrhagical vasculitis or septic vasculitis, hemorrhagical vasculitis or septic vasculitis. You see elements of necrosis in hemorrhagical elements. For example, formation of necrosis. Oh, you see elements of necrosis, yes, in hemorrhagical vasculitis. In fulminant sepsis, formation of massive necrosis, massive hemorrhagical syndrome, disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome, and formation of massive hemorrhagical elements of necrosis. Hemorrhagical vasculitis, yes. Fulminant sepsis. Sometimes syndrome Otterhaus-Friedrichsen, hemorrhagical vasculitis, fulminant forms. Or syndrome Otterhaus-Friedrichsen. It is a fulminant variant of septic shock and disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome. Massive hemorrhagia. Massive necrosis. Formation of metastatic focus of infection. Yes, bacteria's penetration to blood, then penetration to histological barrier and penetrate to internal organs and formation of metastatic focus of infection. In different organs, formation of abscess of tissue, abscess of formation of osteomyelitis, purulent arthritis, metastatic focus in the lung, So it is morphological results. So metastatic purulent meningitis. Yes, because bacteria penetrate to gametoencephalic barrier and cause the formation of purulent meningitis. Sometimes meningoencephalitis and meningitis. You see CT of brain, metastatic focus of sepsis in brain. Many focuses. Characterized by neurological syndrome, paresis, paralysis, clonic cramps, loss of consciousness. It is morphological results. It is metastatic focus. You see in the liver, yes, metastatic focus in the liver. Metastatic focus in the liver. Metastatic focus in the liver, ultrasonic examination, abscess of the liver, yes, abscess of the liver, it's characterized by higher fever, jaundice, abdominal pain, hypertransaminasemia, hyperbilirubinemia. Metastatic focus in the lung. Many little focuses in the lung. Very big metastatic focus in the lung. Formation of destruction pneumonia, respiratory insufficiency. Many metastatic focuses in the lung, you see. Now, we differentiate sepsis and others infection. So we know that sepsis may be in infection disease. For example, salmonellosis, yersiniosis, plague, tularemia, anthrax. So, those infections cause the formation of sepsis too. There are general forms of infection and formation of metastatic focus of infection. For example, salmonellosic sepsis characterized by formation, we observe the patients with gastroenteritis. Alimentary anamnesis, gastroenteritis, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, then high prolonged fever, and formation of polyorgans insufficiency and metastatic focus of infection. Infection agent is Salmonella, for example. Yes, Salmonella. Or metastatic general forms of septic forms of yersiniosis. It is alimentary anamnesis, for example. Gastrointestinal syndrome, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, higher fever, intoxication, and metastatic focus of infection. Symptoms of hood, symptoms of gloves, symptoms of socks, so in general forms of yersiniosis or pseudotuberculosis. For example, general forms of anthrax. Anthrax, it is zoonotic infection. Infection agent is agricultural animals. Yes, contact with animals contact and respiratory mechanism of transmission. At first, formation of carbuncles, then generalization of infection and formation of clinic of sepsis. Cerosal hemorrhagical edema of lung, respiratory insufficiency, and polyorgan insufficiency and death of patient. Then septic forms of plague. Yes, and in analysis of those patients is contact with rodents. So endemic focus of infection, formation of bubon, formation of ulcers on the skin. Yes, at first local forms, bubon forms, ulcers forms, and then generalization of infection and formation of sepsis. So general forms of tularemia, it's characterized by contact with rodents too, formation of buborns, formation of ulcers on the skin, and then generalization of infection. So we differentiate sepsis and collagenosis, for example, yes, it's characterized by the fever and formation of Tajet organs. We differentiation sepsis with neurological disorders, for example, thermoneurose, it's characterized by subfebrility temperature for a long time, many weeks, many months. So we differentiate sepsis and tumors and oncological disease because formation of metastatic focus in different organs, destruction, activation of secondary infection in oncological disease. And diagnostic of oncological disorders is, for example, CAT, MRT, too. Yes. Then, markers of cancer, too. So we differentiate sepsis and AIDS infection. AIDS infection is characterized by immunodeficiency conditions. And we know that very often we diagnostic sepsis in the patients with AIDS infection because sepsis it is opportunistic infection and manifestation sepsis in the patients with AIDS infection in fourth stage of AIDS infection. So we spoke about of sepsis, etiology, epidemiology, pathogenesis, clinic, diagnostic, laboratory diagnostic, and treatments of sepsis, and differentiation sepsis with others infection disease. Thank you for your time. Goodbye.